one more important thing to settle.
UTSA, UT.
Yup.
Now, I think this is going to come down to how many stocks can SQPR take off of Albert. That's how I see it.
It's a safe assumption.
That's how I see it.
The thing is, like, this is going to be hard because this year I would say that UTSA actually has, like, a decent roster overall. Yeah. But, like, the other people they brought, they're no slouches. You got Brian, you got LGT, and you got Bok Choy. On top of all that, I think Peachy King is there. Well, he's pretty good.
Peachy King is solid.
What? All right.
It's more, yeah. All those people you mentioned are good people. Good
so
players.
it's gonna be hard to like steal a deficit from them.
Yeah, definitely. Especially because A. Albert's there. Peachy King plays Peach, so if you don't know how to play Peach, he can rock you. Honestly.
Yeah.
He can rock you. Brian. I feel like Brian's placements at tournaments that I've seen do not reflect his skill.
Higher or lower?
He should be. His skill is higher than he places.
Yes, I'd agree.
His skill is higher than he places. He's good.
Yep.
He just needs to be. I don't know what it is. It's just one of those weird things where it's just something is not clicking or he's not clutching it out. I think it's just not clutching it out.
Yeah. Honestly, I feel like he just doesn't. He sets up pretty well in neutral. He doesn't finish his punishes.
Yeah, definitely. Huh?
Mike? Yep. All right, here we go.
All right.
Game one.
So we have started with one of the more even matchups in the game. Fox Marth.
So this is interesting. Slug's also sort of an X factor here. I know he's got... His punishment game's definitely where he shines. Oh!
Hey, that, okay, Luke.
But UTSA has got something else to say about that.
Now I remember who Luke is.
Yeah.
I think Luke is one of the guys that he was over when you were hosting.
Yeah. Luke's been over a couple times.
Yeah, I remember because I remember he was super. He was really happy because he did get a lot better.
Yep.
I remember now. Because I think months ago when I first got here, I ran all over him, and then he was keeping it pretty close when I played him at your place. So, yeah.
Yeah.
And as we're seeing now, he's nothing to laugh at.
But again, like, this is one of the things, Slug can just run away with it so fast.
Yeah.
It's okay, though. It's Fox. If that was Fox, that would be trouble. But it's Fox McCrowd.
That actually could have been followed up a bit better.
Yeah.
He could have focused more on getting him off towards the stage or doing weak stuff to set up for stronger hits, but he didn't do that. But fortunately, it doesn't really matter. That should be a stock. Bear. Yep. Pretty easy.
Yep. So again, this is where I think... it's really going to determine it because UTSA, if it wants any chance right now, as much as I love the UTSA boys, they've got to kind of run away with this right now. They've got to give them a reason to send out Albert.
Yeah, very well said. Very well said.
Because if they have to get, if they get out to Jeremy or are forced to use Jeremy before then, oh.
Yeah.
It's going to be rough. Like, oh man, I finally got to play Albert in tournament, and he just double three-stocked me. But it wasn't that it was just like it was a double three-stock. It was the entire set was over in 3 minutes.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That's right.
Yeah.
But so, then again, it's probably I played Albert. I wanted to play him for so long.
Yeah.
He's so different.
Yes, he is.
He is different. I can't say anything. There's nothing.
He's a man who a majority of his training was done on his own. Like, he does not get to play people that often besides his brother. So he is a bit of a Dr. Peepee. He had to sit down and analyze a lot of videos and work on it in small ways like that. That definitely reflects his playstyle.
His playstyle reminds me a lot of Zangozen, if you are familiar with him.
Yeah, yeah.
No, he truly reminds me of.
He has a very good control and like understanding of his lasers. He doesn't he doesn't just shoot lasers for like nebulous reasons.
Yep. It's true. Well, hopefully we get to see him play in action, but...
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Oh, but Luke's back. He's like, nah, dog. I know not to quit after those.
Yeah.
You gotta earn this.
Would I like... Ho, 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 ho.
Dang.
That's something that you have to have a lot of experience playing this game. Like, it's good Mars to know that that's coming.
Yeah.
That double jump there.
So...
You have to... Oh, man.
Now's the bigger issue. I don't know who they're going to send in from UTSA. I would like to send in, I think this, it would be a good time to send in Grapefruit because you need to take some risks right now. You need to be willing to go out and start trying to make some greedy plays.
This is true.
Landry.
This actually works too. I play Landry a lot. Whenever I play Landry in Finland, I usually go Marth.
Yep.
And he he does decent.
He does the game.
It's kind of hard to tell because we also do stupid things. I don't know how he plays when he's playing for real.
I've played him a bit in that. I think he is somebody held back by his character.
Okay.
I think like his playing is better than Ganondorf, but on the other hand, like Ganondorf allows you to focus on certain fundamental things.
It would also be nice if you learned how to wavelength onto the stage.
Yeah.
That'd be helpful.
Yeah.
That'd be helpful.
All right.
Now, this also depends on how Kidney plays, because a lot of Mars, when they play against non-fast followers, have no idea what they're doing.
That's actually very true. I see so many like upcoming Mars. They get pretty decent against fast fallers. Like, it's definitely where their skill shines. And will quit Marth or pick up Fox for literally every floaty. And I'm just like, you've wasted all your potential.
Yup.
Because Marth's a good character.
Oh, he's very good. It's just the things that make him, what make people want to play him are things that Mewtwo King-esque things.
Yep.
And Marth requires you to know things about this game that no other character needs to know.
Yeah.
Marth, you need to know certain things.
Ooh. So Slug's
at least if you want to, yeah, you did that too early. At least if you want to be solid, good job. Dude, Landry needs to learn also about a reverse up B.
Yeah.
He doesn't do that very much, if at all. I haven't seen him do it ever.
There's definitely some just Ganondorf tech he could stand to learn. So Slug's already kind of running away.
He has no jump. He has no jump.
Yeah, this is going to be...
He's dead. He's dead.
This is a bad position.
Yeah.
This is what the kind of destruction that we were expecting from, like, Albert. But this is... Oh, no.
That jab was questionable, but...
They should have.
Another thing about mid and low level players, two things. One, you have to learn how to play with pressure,
yeah,
which is, I enjoy these settings for that. But also, you have to learn to have composure,
yeah,
and not just throw out attacks when you're getting hit.
Yeah.
Unless they empty hop into you for whatever reason, you just punch them in the face.
Yep.
But other than, if Kidney can take this stop, Chain grab, you can chain grab that.
Kidney actually needs to take this game super better. Unfortunately, I'm going to like already call it as over. Like, if Slug already takes two, they've got to deal with Brian. They've got to deal with Albert. Like, they're going to need a miracle. Like, LGT's still in the wings. Like, because this would have been a value pick. If he had just... Kidney had just been able to take this set, like, real cleanly... Oh. And it took like a stock in the next one. Like, Kidney's decent, but he's also one of the weaker ones on their team.
Looking at the team, he might be the weakest.
Hmm?
That should have been an up air. Not a fair. Dead.
No, this is bad. So Slug is now taken.
Keith needs to go.
No, it's already too late. You gotta, like, if they want any chance of actually winning, Keith needed to go last time.
Yeah, this is true.
Keith, like, they needed Keith to take two stocks, like, immediately. And Falcon could do that.
This is true. How is Keith versus Falcon's Marth?
It's probably his most practiced matchup.
Nice. Okay. Good.
But that's why I was saying, like, that, because Landry. It was four stocks for one stock.
Yeah. We're up on Ultra Arcade, one of our venues down here. But of course, Slug with the the UT golf polo. Or trainer's polo.
Really hoping.
All right, after this match, I'm actually going to have to head out. I have a birthday plans for a friend of mine.
Okay. So now this is the struggle. like Albert waiting in the wings.
Yeah. Yeah.
But good counterpick, good stage. This could be over in an instant. Good movement so far by Kathan. Oh no. Don't jump into that.
Is that how you say his name? Is it Kathan?
Yeah.
Oh.
I know how it's spelled, but it is Kathan.
Okay. Stop.
Oh, okay.
Why?
He wanted a nipple. Oh, man. All right, whatever. See, but that's what would have happened if they brought in with their counter pick.
And it's what should have happened. Yeah, absolutely right. Because now they're down a whole extra person for whatever reason. Well, it looks like that's time to stay.
Well, it's like, I actually feel that it would have been a better idea to send Landry in against a space animal.
Yeah.
Because one of the things Landry was not able to do against Marth is he was not able to tip maneuver, which is one of the things he does know how to do.
Okay.
This is rough.
CFoy is another person I feel his placement underrepresents his skill.
Yep.
But his flaws are a bit more obvious than Brian's. He's not patient.
Yeah. Honestly, I honestly feel like the main flaws that Brian exhibits, though, is just, like, he doesn't finish his food.
Yep.
Like, really good placement.
Yeah.
He's really good at edge guarding, but, like, when he's given, a solid hit in mid-stage, he doesn't get as much out of it.
Yeah. This is true.
No, don't near out of corner. Something I talk about with a lot of other Falcons. Attacking out of the corner to get out of the corner as Falcon is really bad. Because trades are not... Oh, that was good. Cancel his lag on the platform.
It was also bad on CFoy's part, but...
Yeah.
Still followed up, still finished it.
Oh my god. No.
I think one of the main things about CFoy is his switch between when he's being on offense and defense is very obvious.
Yeah.
It's extremely...
All right.
It's extremely... Stop. He's kind of...
He just kind of died there.
Yeah. Why is he attacking? He's invincible. Why do people do that?
I don't know. I honestly don't...
He could have dropped zoned him.
Yep.
He could have dropped zoned him. He did that forward smash because you heard Falcon... I heard it from here. Falcon. When he's in his get-up attack.
Yep.
So that's why he forward smashed. It was obvious. That was unfortunate. Grapefruit, why you know we grab?
Takes discipline to do that. But on top of that, like, okay, I'm sorry, Kathan's sort of panicking right now. He's just throwing up a bunch of nairs in the middle, and that's actually not a good strategy.
Well, so we're gonna get a CFoy.
But it's not getting him anything.
This is true. You're absolutely right about that.
No, he's gonna lose a lot of stocks to this.
Yeah, it's just like, yeah, he's just doing it because he sees Falcon's doing it. It's supposed to be a good move, blah blah blah. Like right there was no reason to do it there.
Yeah, people
just get out of there, reset the situation.
Okay, good tech.
Like a lot of at the mid levels and especially the lower levels, people don't understand that moving out of a situation is way more important than hitting the other person.
Yeah.
Like right there, that was and it was good because it did both at the same time. But for the most part, that's unfortunate. All right, this crowd is over. Ladies and gentlemen, I have dinner plans. Zaya, good stuff commentating. Until next time.
I'm just gonna...
Yo, it's your boy, Slug. Alright. Let's see what's Gucci in this next game.
Ooh, welcome.
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 It is I, Kidney, that just got by. Somewhat. Alright. Rasha versus CFoy. Oh, snap.
Alright, I haven't played Rasha yet. I've seen him all day, though.
It's pretty good when he's on point. Yeah, definitely. He never had this matchup before. I mean, like, they've never faced each other.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, CFoy is super technical, but sometimes he, like... Sometimes he just kind of goes in too hard.
Yeah, I can kind of see it right there. He's really, like, ham.
Oh, there it is, yeah.
Rasha just messing up his... Wow. Mm-hmm. CFoy has some, you know, getting some good edge guards.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, staying safe.
not putting as much rush, not putting much pressure, but he is
he's staying
like,
hit, safe. He's got good.
Yeah, he's staying really safe. Oh, except that was kind of unsafe. That was nice.
Ooh, that worked out.
That might be one stock. Oh, he didn't edge guard it that well. Surprise.
I'm surprised he got shield grab. That looked pretty safe.
Yeah, it really did. Oh, is another? Oh, okay, that was gonna shorten it again. That was pretty nice.
Just a bunch of recovery.
It's just a bunch of. They have so many options to stop the recovery.
Yeah.
But it seems
and
like
it's always side like unshortened side beats.
Yeah. It's like where's the up tilt to stop it or you know the back hit.
It's actually crazy to think about all the recovery options that spaceys have.
Right?
Like shine stall, shortening,
different angles of upbeats,
and every all 360 degrees. Like,
yeah,
that's
right.
Insane.
They have so many ways of doing this, but it seems like CFoy is taking one stock. Oh, there. Nice. Rasha getting him with that back air. Reverse back air, actually.
He's pretty clean Falco, honestly.
He really is. I'm just surprised not putting like, as the other Falcos, Falcos usually put out a lot of lasers.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
He's not the one to usually do that. He spends more time of getting them with the actual tech.
Yeah.
Shines.
I kind of agree with that playstyle, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, against Fox, like against every character, lasers achieve like a lot, but some you can still like take away Falco's lasers and he'll be a top tier.
Yeah, he really is. The laser just kind of limit the other players somewhat, but you don't need it as a Falco player to still
at
be
top level though. Yeah,
at top level, yeah. But I mean, like around here, you don't really need it.
Yeah.
Oh,
all right.
Not in the range to get on.
Probably gonna take CFoy's stock.
Yeah, he's about in that range. That one, you know, side smash or back air will do it. Ooh. But CFoy has a ways of coming back. And like we mentioned, there hasn't been much stop and recoveries.
Yeah, it's been a pretty sloppy edge guarding overall.
Oh, that's being a little bit okay. Both of them still like kind of filling each other out, trying to be safe and not lose a stock. Oh, he tried to read the long, but he shortened it.
Yeah, Rasha definitely, or at this point, both players definitely staying center stage, not trying to get gimped.
Oh, nice power shield.
Ooh, somehow power shields that shine.
Pretty good. Oh, I'm surprised he went for up and up air.
Ooh, could have been cute.
Nice. Rasha trying to find something.
Rasha about to take it?
He's going to fish out for it.
Oh, yes. Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh, shield drop by
that's
C4.
Okay. Oh,
into a reversal.
Oh, but he came back on stage. It could be anybody's game right now.
Yeah, definitely.
There we go. Oh, to the back here. That could be
some
hit.
DI.
Does he have a... Oh, it's up B reach.
Dude, there's no edge guarding. What is this?
I know. It's it's the greatest. It's all about neutral game.
And C4 is showing.
Oh, he tried to beat it too, but... The roll.
Oh, the air dodge.
Nice into a back air. Missed the laser.
Hit the
up air. Is that going to kill off the top?
Oh,
on a back air. And Rasha taking the game.
That was good.
Bringing UT Austin to their. Was this their third?
This is our third. Yeah. And next tournament, we won't have Albert or Bok Choy, so we need to, like, practice without them.
This is LGT.
Mm hmm.
Oh, yeah. I remember playing against me. Please? Yeah, Fox. I thought so. I got a lot of foxes on your team.
Yeah. We got two foxes, a Falco, a Falcon, and a Mark.
Interesting.
So y'all have a super diverse lineup.
Yeah, like if you want to know the rest of our team, we actually have like a young Link there
really?
And some other stuff. It's kind of crazy. But they couldn't make it.
What is BC?
BC, that is our group bait conglomerate. So we host tournaments and everything. We actually had our first one this week at a bar.
Not like a sponsor though, necessarily. Like
not really yet.
Yeah.
It's not full business, but we're getting there.
Mm-hmm.
So they're just hand warming, all right.
Oh, I thought we turned pause off, but
I think they turned it back on.
Oh yeah.
Let's see. Can Rasha use that one stock he has?
Yeah.
To take at least a one or two from LGT.
I was playing LGT in with Falco earlier, so he's got the matchup pretty down.
Okay. Because, yeah, his Fox is pretty solid. I played against him earlier. I mean, I played against him with different characters, my secondaries and stuff, but...
He's super good against Marth, too.
Yeah.
He's got that tech skill like that.
Because doesn't he plays against a Marth all the time, right?
I don't know who he plays against.
I remember he's got that
tech skill that, like, really helps against Marth.
And we're about to see it now. Here we go. Starting it off, Rasha getting a couple percent in.
Nice. Linking it nicely.
Ooh,
that could have been an up tilt.
That was... There we go.
Ooh, what is this?
He is linking a lot of stuff. What is this? These strings are, like, crazy.
Ooh, good pressure, though, by LGT.
LGT getting out of there. Yeah, he's getting out of the pressure to put his own pressure in. It seems pretty good.
Oh,
nice. Waveland up smash.
My God. Let's see, what can LGT get? They both are at the same percentage. It's like, I'm pretty sure they're both fishing out for something. They're just waiting for one of them to mess up.
Definitely up smash range.
Yeah.
For Falco.
Ooh. Oh, nice. Thought he was going to get something, but he was probably just waiting.
Rosh is getting all these weak hits, but, like, he needs a solid back.
Oh,
here.
Nice. Getting himself out of the corner. Ooh, this is kind of a bad spot for both.
Oh.
This is one hard hit.
Oh, living.
Oh, my.
He's Falco's up smash so bad, not killing on stadium at like 120%.
That is true. If it did kill, I was going to be like, LGT, DI needs a little bit of improvement, but
yeah.
LGT saying, I'm not going to die to some weak hits like that.
You can literally can't see Fox whatsoever.
Oh.
Behind that kid.
Yeah, you just stuck there. You just see
just shine.
I want to see some multi shines right behind it. I'm racking up some more percentage.
Rasha
pretty good.
Needs to grab.
One grab or one back
literally up tilt. Up tilt might kill at this point.
Actually, yeah, you're right.
Oh!
Good DI though.
Oh,
he side B's. Thought he was off stage. Bear.
Oh, misses it.
Oh, he wanted it.
Oh.
Getting the bear in, that might be it.
What?
He got back on. What is this?
Oh, he tries to up smash.
It's reminding me of last game.
Yeah. Oh, the pixels.
Nice, he tried it. That was so close. That should have killed. I'm surprised he didn't kill that far.
Yeah.
He still has. Nice. That was a really close game. I was really thinking Rush was going to get at least one stock from it, but
yeah.
That was pretty close. And here comes the one.
Anchor.
The only. SPQR.
SPQR.
No, it's SPQR. All right. But he's definitely our anchor.
What does he mean?
He mains Marth, but
he definitely said earlier he mained Game & Watch.
He loves Game & Watch, but he mains Marth. Falco and Marth are his thing.
Just like me.
They're probably going to go to the UTSA stage, which is the FD.
FD is the UTSA stage?
That's just only because that's the like where he loves it. But
yeah.
I don't know. I believe in him. Last time I've seen this, he lost to him, but that was because he was down a couple of stocks, and then he kind of tried to prove it afterwards and did it. But I don't believe in him taking 12 stocks.
He's from Albert, like,
exactly.
Four stock Albert.
Alright. That would be something amazing.
Ooh,
but that's not.
That was cool.
That was a pretty interesting thing. He will do some weird mix-up I've seen.
I'm actually excited to see his, like, chain grab potential, or, like, juggling and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I love, like, checking out Marth's, like, FD habits.
Oh, ooh. Nice. Not even a tipper, just hitting him with the base.
Yeah, took that stock way faster than Rasha couldn't take.
Really did.
Couldn't take the stock.
Ooh.
It's like, we don't get to really learn the punish game because we get punished a lot. But definitely LGT racking up some damage on him, keeping him off stage.
Look at his jump. Ooh, that was a situation where Marth Killer wouldn't have worked.
Yeah, he was too high above it. You literally need to be like right below the stage.
Ooh,
nice.
Oh, second shine would have been juicy.
Putting out shines.
Yeah, no, he's super good against Marth. He like doesn't mess up his tech skill as much against Marth for some reason.
Oh, missing that grab. Surprise, SPQR.
All these full hops are definitely missed wave dashes.
Oh, that's what it actually is?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, okay. That might get him killed for one stock at least, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna fix himself. I've seen LGT too much to see like I know he's not gonna like do that repeatedly.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
All right. Oh my god. Sword Dance into forward smash. That is like kind of his special for no reason.
Yeah. Two hits of Sword Dance, forward smash.
Yeah. He'll do some weird stuff like that. Can I see if LDT can catch on to it?
Ooh, gets in with the grab.
Oh, is he going to get a...
No? Ooh, I don't think he meant that.
He's just racking damage on him. He's not even really trying.
Ooh.
Oh, is he going for it? Oh, well, just pushing him back off to the side. That should be a kill.
All right.
117%. Is he going to... Oh. I'm just really surprised. SPR is not going out there. Usually he's like a maniac going off the platform.
Like right there. That yeah. Go off right there. All right. Ooh, good tech chase.
LGT at one stock. Pretty sure he can take another one. These up airs. Oh, nice. SPQR doing a good job of making sure.
Ooh, tipper. That's so optimal.
He has a chance to come back though.
Is this gonna combo?
Oh! Really though?
Sick!
Two stocks.
Comboed up smash into a Ken combo.
That is crazy. Now down to 8 stocks. Who is the next man to come in? They have Albert and who else?
Bok Choy.
Bok Choy, okay, yes, I remember him.
Yeah, we don't want to use Albert this time. He carried us way too hard. He took 16 stocks
in the last
group battle.
That was just
messed
epic.
Up.
He was on 2 stocks the whole time, right?
Yeah, yeah. Like, he took 2 of the first person stocks and then 2 of the last person stocks. That's how it worked out.
I did not understand. I was like, someone get one more stock at least.
Yeah.
Albert is definitely a force to be reckoned with. Mm-hmm. They're going back to FD. All right. PR getting rid of his last stock. There we go. Can he take out a Falcon?
Bok Choy's pretty good. I like the way Bok Choy plays. Falcon mains always earn my respect. Just
they always do. Their combo game is just too real.
Yeah.
That's why I kind of want to see. I've seen him play, but I've never seen a.
Ooh!
Oh, wow. Never, because I want to see this matchup so much. I was expecting it since the start.
Mm-hmm.
SPQR is really good against Falcons, or at least he's played Zaya and a Falcon on our team.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
no, Zaya's good. Zaya's got hella dash dance skills.
Yeah, I know Bok Choy is like a really good Falcon. That's why I want to see how this will go.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Okay.
Ooh, that up air link.
But this Falcon is just getting out hit from these swords.
Ooh,
nice.
Good DI. I think 4th hit might have worked there. Living.
Oh! He is actually coming back.
Trip him up. Oh, no, he's good. Living again.
That is one thing I would hate if I don't like it, Falcon. Landing on the stage is your weakness.
Yeah, no, you should be going for ledge on this.
Oh, definitely. That's a little too far now.
That's a little unsafe.
That was pretty good edge guarding from SPQR.
Ooh, first hit. Nice.
What the? Getting hit with, like, first part of the gentleman. Nice into me.
All right, last talk for UTSA. Can he bring it back?
No. But, he could. Definitely, he's played against this matchup before. He should know exactly how to deal with most of the moves. But Bok Choy is getting these combos in.
Ooh.
What is this? Oh.
I thought he was just going to go for the dare when he was off stage, but he brought him back on.
Just waiting for him. Getting him with another knee.
There
he
it is.
Too far to come back. There is no way.
Oh, what a story!
All he had to take.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh.
I'm just speechless.
That orange, the orange Falcon punch for UT, just
like
boom.
Right in the face, just wow.
Oh,
we just
that
kinda,
Falcon punch.
That was kind of one of them highlights right there.
Yeah.